how ablations are traditionally done is, you know, there's a patient, they're sedated, and then we place equipment through their veins and arteries up into their heart. We have in the room a variety of screens and monitors that display real-time information for us. It can be as many as like 4 or 5 monitors that we're looking at.
This is sort of a free canvas that we can design to have live video images. For example, in this case, we have the 3D mapping of the heart, we have the patient vitals, and we have the live ultrasound images.
Fred Hazal with Biomed Engineering reached out to me and said, hey, you know, we're really interested in pushing the needle of how we can use, you know, an Apple Vision Pro for patient care.
Depending on the procedure, this data can change.
We thought this would be a great use case for this technology. We're then able to do a start to finish atrial fibrillation ablation, from accessing the patient's femoral veins to performing the ablation to closing the device, doing it all while wearing an Apple Vision Pro, and then having the ability to consume all of that data and information through a augmented reality screen that wasn't visible to other people in the room.
The operating room is augmented reality anyways, right? We're trying to create view into the inside of the heart and put it on a screen so that we can navigate within it. It's just done in a sort of a haphazard way, whereas the device is just more intuitive.
You have a lot of control over the placement of this data that you're consuming. For example, you know, with hand motions, I can take the monitor, move it to anywhere in the room that I would like. I can take the information, I can scale it to any size I want. I can take a screen that, you know, shows the images of someone's heart in real time and make it miniature, or make it the same size as like an IMAX studio. And so that's a really kind of unique and novel way to be able to interact with and consume that data during the procedures. I don't think there are ethical concerns about saying, hey, let's bring a new 4K monitor in that is higher def than the monitors we currently have. It's just that it's projected inside of a computing spatial headset. We're hoping to add that additional layer where you can move the screens, but you can reach in and touch the data itself.
But what if we could actually just take the three-dimensional model and put it in the patient where the heart actually is and move the tool? It would be much more intuitive. What if we're doing a new procedure that hasn't been done before at Stanford? You could have somebody proctor from somewhere else. They could see that three-dimensional model. It's a perfect space to really flex this technology. The procedures are all done very minimally invasively.
The procedures where we use this, they went great. We had great outcomes. The patients did great. They couldn't have gone smoother.